प्रेस सब्सक्राइब बटन फॉलोड बाय बेल बटन एंड क्लिक ऑल टू गेट मोर टॉपिक। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस सेशंस वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट क्वांटम नंबर्स फॉलोड बाय सर्टेन सेट ऑफ रूल्स फॉर राइटिंग इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑफ बॉब प्रिंसिपल, हंस रूल ऑफ मैक्सिमम मल्टीप्लिसिटी and N plus L rule, Pauli exclusion principle. These all will help you that how many electrons will be occupying a particular shell or in the subshell or in that individual orbital, as well as you will be able to write the electronic configuration of any species, whether it is a neutral atom and cation and anions. Okay, for which you need the atomic number, because atomic number will give you or help you to find out the number of electrons. For writing the electronic configuration, number of electron, because the electronic configuration means arrangement of electrons around the nucleus. It will be done by knowing the number of electron, which can be calculated from the atomic number. That all we discussed in the previous classes. Okay, but here see, look at this right hand side of this board, what all I have given. This is the reality. I have listed some realities. And if you understand these realities, the same type of questions asked anywhere, you will be able to tackle the question and answer that. The explanation for these questions will be based on this new concept, that is extra stability of half filled and completely filled configuration, which I am going to discuss with you today. These realities, these facts, these behavior of different species cannot be explained by the previous set of rules. That Aufbau principle, N plus L rule, Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity, by which you wrote the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p, 3s, 3p, that sequence, then it will not answer these questions. This is realities. Again, one more thing, many times I have told you, theories are proposed for explaining the reality. If the reality is not explained by the already existing theory, you have to make a new theory. It is not necessary that old theory has to be removed or rejected, because the old theory was capable of explaining many species. Only in some few species in the periodic table, these type of things, facts cannot be explained by those theories. So those theories will be remaining. In addition to that, some more theories required. These are limitations of those theories. These are anomalies of those theories. So we have to introduce a new theory, and that new theory is the extra stability of half filled and completely filled. What is that? We'll discuss one by one. Before that, you have a look on this, we'll have a glance on this, because at the end of this class, you all should be able to answer these questions. Here, some of them will be understood by the class 11 students, some of them only in class 12 related, that I have included those things also. Okay, so in class 11 students, after studying the periodic table, long form of periodic table, you will understand most of the cases. You can try the other things also, though it is in the class 12 in different chapters. See, it is, I told you in the previous class, related to ionization enthalpy, related to oxidation state. See, many are oxidation states. Why some oxidation states are more stable? One simple example I will give you. First of all, you see that this is the first one I have written. This is supposed to be by the previous set of rules. This is the one, but it is not explaining the reality. So this is not the electronic configuration. This is the electronic configuration. Then why? Same thing is for copper. Here, this is supposed to be the electronic configuration, but that cannot explain. See that what it cannot explain? Copper is forming stable compound in plus one oxidation state. Or I can say that copper plus is more stable than copper 2 plus. This also we can include in gaseous state. In gaseous state, if you discuss, if you see that copper plus is more stable than copper 2 plus, which cannot be explained by the electronic configuration written on the top based on this Aufbau principle, N plus L, that set of rules. But it can be explained now after understanding what is this half filled and completely filled stability. Same thing here also, chromium plus 1 compounds are there. That plus 1 compounds can be explained only by this second configuration, and which will be explained by the new theory, that is extra stability or half filled or completely filled configuration. Okay, so now here one more thing also that you have to include, that it will be very much helpful. Just I am giving the rough diagram. So just so you consider this increasing order, some property increasing. And the first one I am giving is that you see, start from this lithium. Okay, lithium up to that lithium in, that is a period number. Second, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, that one. So what happened, this it will be going on decreasing. Okay, this is a going on decreasing up to fluorine. Okay, what is it? This is atomic size. Atomic size will be, so this is a quantity, atomic size you consider, therefore it is going on decreasing. All of you can understand the meaning of graphical representation, decreasing. Suppose if this axis is representing about the ionization enthalpy, it is supposed to be like this. This is the lithium to fluorine, ionization enthalpy is supposed to be like this, because ionization enthalpy is more when the size is smaller. When the size is small, see here, ionization enthalpy is more, see that more, from when compared to here, it is more increasing because size is low. That effective nuclear charge, the electrons attracted by the nucleus will be very strong when the size is smaller. You all have studied that. And this is the expected. This is expected. But what is the actual real one? If you see that, what is that? If you look at that, I will draw separately. If you look at this ionization enthalpy, starting from lithium up to fluorine, if you see that, in this is the trend expected. Size decreases, therefore it should increase. But what happened, if it is going, that you see that this lithium, next one will be beryllium, and after that beryllium, what happened, this boron will come down slightly, then after that carbon. Then after that carbon, it is nitrogen. And nitrogen, after nitrogen, oxygen. See that? This is actual. Ionization enthalpy, instead of increasing gradually due to decrease in size, it was having this, what is that, violation. The trend is supposed to go straight. Then question comes here, why? Here, why it is like this? Question comes. It can be now very well explained. At the end, we will discuss these two questions. Why it is like this, it will be explained by this off-filled and completely filled configuration. Okay, now comes your question in your mind, sir, what is this half-filled and completely filled? After that, why it is more stable? Why it is more stable? Half-filled means what? Any orbital. Even I will include that S orbital. You take, this is S orbital. And this is P orbital. Okay, because it is a degenerate, in single box we are writing, mean it is a degenerate, all three will be px, py, pz, will be having same energy. Similarly for d orbital, and you can include, though the shapes are not available, that at least in the box representation 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is S orbital, and this is P orbital, this is d orbital, this is F orbital. Okay, now first of all, we'll discuss what is half-filled and completely filled. As here, half-filled means what? Its capacity is any orbital. This is single box, is an orbital. The single box, any orbital, maximum electron is 2 electron. One is plus of spin and minus of spin. Okay, so here this is 1 electron. And here 1, 2, 3. Half-filled means 50%. This is 50% filled, that is half-filled. 100% filled means what? That is completely filled. Okay, now you can understand that what is completely filled. Completely filled is these 2 electron. What is this completely filled here? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and similarly here, what is this completely filled for d orbital? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so this is completely filled. And this is half filled. Here again I am filling this D half filled, F half filled. And again similarly F fully filled also you can write. Okay. Now what is this? This is S1. This is P3. And this is D5. Because they are having 5 orbital, each 50% means one electron. This is F7. So this S1, P3, D5,
F7. These are all half filled. Completely filled is what? S2 and P6, D10 and F will be 14. Okay, just imagine I have filled that. Okay, F14. Out of these, I am going to take in this discussion only about PDF. Why that PDF? Because that extra stability, this half filled and completely filled orbitals will have some extra stability. It is because of two reasons. I am going to explain one by one. One is symmetry. One is the symmetrical nature of that arrangement. The second one is exchange energy. Exchange energy. Okay, the second one you have to take care. The first one is simple one, that is by nature you all can understand. Okay, any symmetrical arrangement will have more stability. All of you clear? You just take, you see, there are some 100 bricks I am giving in your hand. You arrange it simply. Anybody is keeping one by one in a zigzag manner, irregular manner, it will not be stable. After some arrangement, it will fall down. What it shows, that is, you are irregularly arranging means it will fall down. And at the same time, you arrange it in a proper sequence, in a symmetrical manner, 1, 2, 3, 4, another one in this vertical and horizontal, like that, you, in some particular pattern, in a systematical manner, in a symmetrical manner, you arrange, it will be more stable. Okay, so this is by law of nature. Anywhere there is a symmetry, it will be more stable. Remember that. So this is no explanation required. This is symmetrical. Any symmetrical, then you say, how the symmetrical comes? I will come to this later on, why it is excluded. Okay, this symmetry, if you want to understand the symmetry, you make it as a single electron. This is just a representation. Electron is not like this. This is for explaining to you, we are using this single headed or double headed arrow mark. Anything you can use. Now see that there is a symmetry. There is a symmetry. There is a symmetrical arrangement. All 50% everywhere uniformly one electrons are given. Here two electrons. See, there is a symmetry. There is a symmetry. Here also there will be a symmetry. Only this off field, this is 50% P capacity is 6 and 3 means 50%, 6 means 100%. D capacity is 10 electron, 5 means 50% off field, 10 means 100% completely filled. Okay, so both of them are having symmetry. Okay, so they have a symmetry. By nature, symmetrical arrangement will be more stable. Sir, here also symmetry is there. Yes, I will come to that. Next one is exchange energy. What is that meaning of exchange energy? Here, this also I told you a new theory so that these realities can be explained. And they studied about that, what may be the reason other than Aufbau principle, N plus L rule, Hund's rule, what can be the reason these realities shown by the different elements and their species. Then they thought of that, it was that better thinking. A better approach leads to this new concept, new theory, that is exchange energy. What they say is, according to this exchange energy, you just write down what is exchange energy. In any it is only applicable for degenerate orbitals. In degenerate orbitals, electron with same spin can exchange their position. Okay, electron with the same spin can exchange their position. What do you understand by that? Is suppose you take this D5. Okay, this D5 configuration you take. In this D5, see, all of them are with the same spin. Okay, now when they are exchanging, see, these two can exchange. This can come here, this can, because they are all same energy. You calculate this, if it is 3D, 3 plus D is what? 2 is equal to 5, N plus L rule. This is also 3D XY, 3D YZ, 3D XZ, 3D X square minus Y square, 3D Z square. Ready be different names are given depending upon their orientation by magnetic quantum number. But this is N value and this is L value will decide the energy. And see that 3D XY, YZ, anything you calculate 3D only, 3 plus 2, 5, that. And principal quantum number also same. By using the both concepts of that N plus L rule, all of them are having same energy. So there is no harm that going, nothing will prevent them exchanging their position, because energy is not changing. Let us see that in exchange energy is not changing because they get their same energy. Okay, but now this can go to here, this can go to here, this can go to here. So this is already over. Then this 1, 2, 3. Then after that, this one here and here, and this 2. Totally 10 exchanges. 10 exchanges possible here. Let us see in other places. If it is suppose D4, not off field, less than that, only D4 means what is that? 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and here 1, 6 only will be there. Here at 10 exchanges of that. Then sir, what is the difference between 10 exchanges in D5 and 6 exchanges in D4? That is, that energy is changed, the energy of that atom, energy of the species changes. Why? Because even though electrons' energy is not changing, because dxy, dyz, these two are dxy and yz or zx or x square minus y square, same energy among them, they get interchanged. But the interchange is over. You may see one brick here, another brick here, both of them are having same potential energy. Assume that their mass is exactly same. So two bricks are kept on the table, both their energies are same. But now you take them, keep it that side and keep it here. After that, now also you are not increasing the height, you are not lowering the height. So now also their potential energy is same. But when you exchange, what you have done, you have spent some energy, your muscular energy you have spent, energy is spent. So this is a phenomenon, exchange of electron is a phenomenon, therefore some amount of energy will be spent. Spent means who will spend? That is atom only. So if there is an atom, and if this exchange is going on, happening, they will release energy. When they are releasing energy, what happened? Lowering of energy takes place. Energy of that atom decreases. So during these exchanges, atom is, that means 10 possibilities, 6 possibilities. That means 10 times exchange is possible, mean that much energy will be released by the atom. Therefore, its energy will be less. Okay, so here that is the reason energy less means, you know, in chemicals, what is that? Low energy, stability will be more. So now you tell me if this D5 is more stable or D4 is more stable. Check up this. Both the points you check up, not only one point. See, in D4 there is no symmetry. In D5 there is a symmetry. Okay, so this I'll write separately, clearly I will write. See, D4 and D5 you take. This is a D4 and a D5 configuration I am going to explain with you, and one more example also I will take. Here in D4 and D5, 1, 2, 3, 4 electron. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 electrons. Now look at these two configuration. Here first is symmetry. There is no symmetry. See, there is no symmetry. One incomplete is there. There is no symmetry. And here there is a symmetry. So by symmetry, this is more stable. And then you come to the number of exchanges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then between these two. So totally 6 exchanges. Here if you already have explained 10 exchanges. So by this symmetry and the number of exchanges, this D5 is more stable. The next question comes in your mind that D5 versus what about that the number of electron increases, C6. Okay, so here D5, the symmetry is there and 10 exchanges. Okay, but here in D6 you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Due to this one single electron here, paired up, this is symmetry is lost, no symmetry, and number of exchanges again 10, because this electron, newly joined electron, is not having any other electron with the same spin, so it cannot have an exchange, so 10, so this is more stable. Then sir, what about the D7? Okay, D7 mean here one electron will come. So first you take it as plus of, and this all plus of like that, and that means this is minus of spin, and this new electron is minus of, so this one exchange will be extra. Okay, so here when compared to D5 and D7, same thing, D8 means 12 exchanges, but what is that? The number of exchanges slightly increasing, one exchange increase. But we have to see both the factors. Here there is no symmetry one side, yes, because symmetry is the law of nature. Symmetry will have high stability. Okay, so here number of exchanges are slightly differing, but the symmetry is present in D5. Here no symmetry, so this D5 will be again more stable when compared to D7, D8, D9 and all. But D5 and D10, if you compare, then definitely D10 will be more stable when compared to the D5 configuration dealing with the same orbital 3D, 3D or 4D, 4D or 4F. 4F like that. Okay, so I hope that you understood well about what is the reason these half filled and completely filled orbitals are having extra stability. Now let us check up whether it is true, whether this theory can explain this or not. You see that chromium, I told you this is the electronic configuration by the old rules, Hofbauer principle, Hund's rule and all. Okay, but it is not the one. Why it is not the one? Because chromium forms compound in +1 oxidation state. Copper forms compound in +1 oxidation state. Chromium plus compounds, copper plus cuprous, you know that. Highly stable, less stable, medium stable, doesn't matter. They form stable compound. That is not possible by considering this configuration. Now see that in this configuration, you see D5, I told you already, is one electron, the two, now one electron will go from 4s to 3d4, becoming 4s1, 3d5. Here, one electron is going from here to here, low energy to high energy, I already explained that. Okay, so here, suppose you consider this chromium atom is having one energy x. When they will absorb some energy, 3 energy they are absorbing. Why they are absorbing? To go from the lower energy to higher energy. By absorbing only they can go. Assume that they have absorbed 3. But after going, what is happening? After going, they get the stability in exchanges and symmetry. They are obtaining symmetry, previously no symmetry. Exchanges also, here 6 exchanges, here 10 exchanges. So they get more stability. Energy is lowered, they lose energy, 7. So totally x minus 4. See, when compared to the x energy, now it has become x minus 4. And which is acceptable? Not that x energy, x minus 4 will be more stable, more spontaneous reaction, and here the change is understood. Why the electron is going from here to here? To become more stable. So that is chromium configuration is this one. Copper also again D10. Right, and now see that +1 oxidation state, here only one electron is present, only one electron. This is the valence shell, this is the valence shell. Those who know that electron is lost from the valence shell, only one electron, so +1 oxidation state compound will be formed. Right, next one is manganese. Manganese is a very good oxidizing agent in Mn3+. So Mn, and this is Mn3+. It is a strong oxidizing agent. It is found from the experimental data I have given the question. Okay, now Mn is 25 atomic number. So here if you write the electronic configuration, argon 4s2 3d5, 25 mean 3d5 will come. Right, now what happens if it is becoming Mn3+, the first these two electron will go, then one electron, because this is the valence shell. And then one electron, because 3 electrons should be lost to become this. Okay, so here it is argon configuration and 4s0 3d4. This is the manganese 3+ compound. You take the manganese 3+ compound, it is acting as a strong oxidizing agent. Which can act as a strong oxidizing agent? Anything which can undergo reduction easily. Let us check up. Anything which can undergo reduction, it will be a good oxidizing agent. For undergoing reduction means what? Gain of electron. Gain of electron is reduction. So first I'll check one electron is gained. It becomes Mn2+. One electron is gained means what will happen? Argon and 4s0, that D5, because it is off-field stability. See, here no off-field stability. Here it is getting off-field stability. This is more stable. This is less stable, therefore more stable change will be less stable to more stable change will be easily taking place. Reduction is easy, therefore this can be a good oxidizing agent. Okay, next coming to this palladium. That palladium is having the atomic number I have written 46. It is in the period number 5 it comes. Okay, so that means previous period, noble gas, helium, neon, argon, krypton. Okay, so here the configuration of palladium is krypton. And then after that 5s2 4d, and this will be in that d8 configuration. If you check up, it comes below nickel group number 10. You check up group number 10 means that d8 will be filled as per the normal configuration. D1 2 3 from scandium, 1 2 3 4, you count in the d8 position nickel. That means below that palladium, platinum also will have only that 5 4, this number will change. So this is the configuration as per the normal rules, but this is not correct. I am not telling reality. What is the reality? You look at this. Palladium is diamagnetic. Who says that experimentally found that mu value is zero? For this palladium, the experimentally found mu dipole moment value, the magnetic moment value is equal to zero. And experiment means it is a fact, reality. So this is by theory you have written. Now you have to change it. That means palladium is having this krypton configuration and 5s0 4d10. You may ask a question, sir, why, sir? Why can't it be d8? See that here, if you write this is 5s and this is 4d. See, 1, 2, this 5 is 2, this is 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. See, here up to this it is paired electron, and there are two unpaired electron. Whenever unpaired electron is there, there should be a mu value. Each and every unpaired electron will contribute to the magnetic moment. That means if palladium is supposed to have this one as per the old set of rules, it is supposed to show some good amount of magnetic moment mu value. But here it is not giving experimentally, it is not giving, reality is not giving. Now you look at this, here one more electron comes, one more electron D10, and now see that all of them are paired. From here to here, all of them are paired, mu is equal to zero. So this explains. Then question comes, sir, why it has to move from here to here? That is to become stable. Anything will like to become stable. So how it will become stable? The same thing, it will going from lower energy to higher energy, some energy is required, +3, but after going it becomes -3, energy is lost. That means overall that energy is decreasing. Overall the energy is decreasing. So this is the palladium configuration, not the D8 configuration. Okay, remember that. The next one is manganese 2 plus compounds are more stable than ferrous Fe 2 plus compound. Then you write the electronic configuration and check out. This is 25 atomic number, this is 26. So this is argon 4s2 3d5. This is argon 4s2 3d6. This is neutral manganese, this is neutral iron. And now Mn2+, you check up. Mn2+ is argon, and valence shell only electron will go. So 4s0 3d5. Here Fe2+, you write argon, and 4s0, because this is a valence shell, electron will go from valence shell only, 3d6. You see the 3d6, 3d5. By off field, it is more stable. So since Mn2+ compounds in which Mn is in the +2 oxidation state has a d5 half field configuration, it is stabilized by this concept, more stable. This is less stable. Understood. Now lastly, this will be very much helpful for that D and F block chapter in class 12, that you will be discussing about this. I am going to take this, is, you know, hydrogen, this is the periodic table, just you keep in your mind, this is the periodic table. Here you will find two rows. The first row is that lanthanoids, and this is actinoids. Okay, so this lanthanoid is what? This is 4F series, 4F 1 to 14 will come. This is 5F 1 to 14, that means 14 elements here, 14 elements, and here also 14 elements. Okay, and this first one will be F1, that is 4F1, 4F2, like that, and then 4F7 will come, then here it will be 4F14. I am not taking all the elements, I am taking, this is actually period number 6, it will happen. That means period number 5, noble gas configuration is what? And helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon. Okay, so here for these 4F series, xenon configuration plus what is that? 6th period, so 6s2 will be filled, but on anomalies that is 5d1 will be filled and 4f1 to 14. Okay, this is the thing. I am not taking all the elements, I'll take only few elements. The 7, if you look at the periodic table, these 7, in this 7 it will be gadolinium. And here before that europium and terbium will be there, and this is the second last F13, that is only that ytterbium will be there. I am going to take these three elements. Okay, before that this 1 to 14, let it be 1 to 14. Now what is the common oxidation state? Common oxidation state of all these elements. Generally common oxidation state you will arrive at from the electronic configuration by the set of rules. What is that electronic configuration? This is valence electron. Okay, so this valence electron will definitely take part in bonding, so +2. And this 5d only one electron is also highly unstable, so this also will take part in bonding, so the common oxidation state is +3. All these elements in this particular lanthanoid category, they will be forming compound in +3 oxidation state, common one expected from the electronic configuration trend. Okay, but here in reality it was found that europium is forming compound in +2, terbium is forming compound in +4, and ytterbium is again forming compound in +2. That's what I have given. That is reality. These compounds are known. Now, why then it is going to beyond this +3 or one less than that? In addition to this +3, it shows this configuration that is related to half-filled and completely filled configuration. Now, I am coming to this europium, and I think the remaining you can understand easily. In europium, that is xenon configuration, 6s2, 5d1, 4f6. This is by the normal rules, that the ordinary rules you have already discussed, no? That is the electronic configuration, but actually this is not the electronic configuration, this will become 7. Same like that chromium and copper we discussed, no? The first one is from the normal rules, but this new rule is not accounted, actually this is the configuration. That is why +1 compounds are known. Similarly, yeah, that is the reason +2 compounds are known, stable. Right? Okay, so this is the actual configuration. Now you think about this, how many electron it will lose involving bond formation. This valence electron 2 will be, so it will become europium 2 plus and 6s0, 5d0, 4f7. See, half filled stability. So these two only will take part, and it will not take an electron, because if you are trying to take electron from this stable one, which will become F7, which is not stable, and you need to spend lot of ionization enthalpy, lot of energy required for removing, that energy will not be met with the bond energy. When it goes for bond, that bond enthalpy will not be compensating this energy because of its high stability. Understand, that is the reason it will form +2. Similarly, here what happened? In terbium also I will explain. In terbium, it will be 6s2 and 5d1 and 4f8, because gadolinium 7, this is 8. And now, if it is losing this electron, +2. If it is losing this electron, on +1 oxidation state. So that in +3 oxidation state, that is the common one, it will be having F8. But one more electron is also involving, mean it will become F7. See, 6s0, 5d0, 4f7. This is for what? This is for terbium 4 plus. And definitely it will be stable because of the stable half-filled configuration. You try this, similarly you try this ytterbium. Here D14, the D electron will come here to become D14. So only that S2 electron will take part, +2 oxidation state will be shown. F14 fully filled stability is there. So I hope that all of you understood what is this new concept, that is half filled, completely filled, having extra stability by symmetry and exchange energy. And this is explaining all these realities. Many more questions are there. This is enough. If you have understood any question related to this off field, completely field stability, you will be able to tackle that question and answer correctly. Okay, so make thorough symmetry and exchange energy makes this off field and completely field to become more stable.